We have seen many unique features of action research, but we shall now see how exactly the various aspects of the action research, they differ from the other types of researches which we have termed as formal research in this case. So, we shall now see the points of differentiation between the two. Now, as we know that while taking up the formal research, an extensive training of the researcher is needed. As compared to this extensiveness, in case of action research, the researcher does not need that much training, and it is more of his or own work or with the consultation of the experts. The goal of research in case of formal research is the generation of the knowledge that is generalizable, which has more applicability for the larger group. In case of action research, the goal is generation of knowledge, yes, but it is only for application in the local situation, and the local situation is that of the practitioner. How is the problem identified that is studied? In case of formal research, this method of identifying the problem is through the review of previous researches, and in case of action research, the method is very simple, like problems or goals that are currently faced. So, the keen observation about the own situation and maybe little open mind for it would generate the problems in case of action research. In case of formal research, the procedure of literature review is very much extensive, and it basically uses primary resources. In case of action research, this literature review is more cursory, and it uses more of secondary resources. So, the action research does not demand the use of primary resources for the literature review. The sampling approach in case of formal research is random sampling, and it is ensured that the sampling is a representative sampling of the population. In case of action research, the randomness or the representativeness is not in the focus, but the students or the clients with whom the practitioner is working, they are in the focus, and they are taken as a part of the sample. The research design is very much rigorous in case of formal research, and there are more controls. The time frame is much longer. In case of action research, the procedures are loose. They can be changed even during the study. Suppose it is something has been planned earlier, and the teacher or the practitioner notices that here is the point where the change is immediately needed, the teacher is allowed to do that. The quick time frame is there, and control is basically through the triangulation. Now, this triangulation is of the quantitative part. Suppose the scores in the tests that are obtained before and after, and also through the they are matched with the observations, with the listening during the conduction of the research. So, that is what happens in case of action research. In case of formal researches, the measurement procedures are used for evaluation and pre-test, post-test measures. In case of action research, it is more of a convenient measures, and standardized tests could be also used in case of action research. The data analysis in case of formal research is conducted through the statistical tests, and mainly through the qualitative techniques as well, if it is the qualitative research. In case of action research, the focus is on practical data analysis and not so much on the statistical significance is considered into, and the statistical significance is not in the focus, and the raw data is also presented in case of action research. The application of the results in case of formal research is more on the emphasis of theoretical significance. So, the overall theory building is the focus. So, the results are used for theory building. In case of action research, the emphasis of the result is on more on the practical significance of the action research. As we have seen through these differences, the action research, the process is not so much rigorous. It is for more for solving one's own problem, the practitioner's own problems, and the implications are also for the practitioner as against the other forms of researches. We have seen lot many aspects of action researches. We will now see what are the ethical considerations while conducting the action research. In research, we always say that the person who are involved in the research should be intimated about what is going to happen with them, and it is all the more applicable when we come to action research. Here we say that the persons who are involved or the groups who are involved in action research should be consulted beforehand. They should be told in detail about what is exactly going to happen with them as a part of the action plan and conduction of action with them. And it is only with their consent one should take up these actions with the group or with the participants. In while planning the action for the participants, the teacher considers a certain way of action from them, but it may not happen that the participants would conduct in the same manner, or they would do suppose they are doing an experiment, they would conduct in the same manner. So the action researcher should give them the freedom of doing it in their own way. At times it may also happen that some of the participants are not interested in participating in the action plan, and this wish of not participating should be respected by the action researcher. As we have seen, the whole effort of action research is a collaborative effort. So, the action researcher should make it a point that they all participate in the in this collaborative endeavor, and their individual differences or individual opinions which may not be in consensus with the action researcher, they should be respected, and even the action researcher should be open to all kind of differences of opinion and also the criticism on the action plan that has been planned and has been implemented. The action researcher, when conducts the action, he has access to lot of documents or lot of work that the participants are generating during that whole plan of action. So, it is the responsibility of the action researcher to take the permission in advance that he can say that this you will be drawing these pictures during this session, and I request that I may please be let me please have the access to these pictures for analysis. And only after having these permissions from the participants for the material that they are generated, then the action researcher should use them for the analysis further. One of the roles which we discuss about action researcher is was that of a reporter. So, the efforts that the action researcher has taken, one feels that they need to be published, and one wants to share it with the other persons in the field. Now, while sharing this effort through publication, many a times the researcher needs to quote or give examples of how the change was brought in the participants and so on. And during this process, one needs to give the actual work, maybe the photographs of it, or maybe sometimes the words that are used. So the ethical point over here is, for such publication, the researcher should again get back to the participants, show them how exactly it is appearing in the publication, maybe a research article, and seek the consent of that participant to share it in that manner, and only then use it in the publication for the maybe for a journal. The last ethical consideration is about the confidentiality. Now, this is in very much consensus with the ethical practices that are followed even in case of any other researches. But in case of action research, it necessarily deals with the human beings, and very close interaction happens between the practitioner and the participants. So, here the researcher should give the participants that confidence that whatever sharing is being done, or whatever maybe incidental observations, or maybe deliberate observations, or deliberate data collection from them, everything will be used only for the purpose of this research, and it will not be shared with somebody else, or it will not be used against them. That confidence needs to be given to the participants, and only after having this confidence with the action researcher, the participants would be wholeheartedly participating in the process of action research. As against the other kinds of researches, here the interactions between the action researcher and the participants, they are already in existence even before the action research comes into picture, because the student and teachers, they are already interacting with each other. Even if there was no research, they will still keep interacting even after the research. So the human bond between the practitioner and the participant, it is very, very crucial, and it does exist. And for especially for the maintaining the sanctity of this bond, the faith in this bond, it is very crucial that all these ethical practices are followed while conducting the action research. As we have seen that the action research differs from the formal research in many aspects, and this point of differentiations are carried out further when it comes to even reporting. In normally in case of while reporting a research, the third person, normally while reporting the research, the researcher is addressed as a third person. So the language is something like the decision was taken, or the researcher conducted. This kind of a language is used. But when it comes to action research, it is my situation, my problem, and my solution. So it is very much the researcher owns all this, and this owning comes even in the form of a language while reporting the action research. So while reporting the action research, the words used are like it was my school, I was a teacher, or I am a teacher in this class, and I teach so and so subject, and these are my students. So it is all the way me, my, it was my reflection, I felt the need, and even later on this was my learning through the whole process. So everywhere in the whole process of writing the report, or reporting the whole effort of action and research, that me aspect of the researcher is very much in focus, and that is carried out right through the beginning till the end of the research. Another important feature of action research report is the evidences that are gathered while conducting the action plan. Now, whether this particular action was successful or otherwise has to be judged at the end. And this judgment doesn't remain only at the level of the gut feeling by the action researcher, but it should be something that the others who are not practicing or who were not the part of that situation should be able to see. So, this kind of evidences are definitely gathered and they are also given as a part of the action research report, so that the other persons, other maybe evaluators or other researchers, other scholars could see the efforts made and exactly how the change was brought in. That is definitely shared. There are at times this action research is reported not as a form of a formal document which has say a title, objectives, research methodology and so on. But we will see many a times that this is this whole effort is narrated in the form of say a kind of a story or details of like own vignette kind of sharing. At times it could be also shared in the form of say a poster. In fact, a poster could be a very good media for sharing the efforts made through the action research and results that are obtained. The advantage here being the getting the visual aspect to what is exactly achieved through the process. Taking this visual aspect further, maybe creating a small documentary or a short film based on the whole effort of action research is also a good idea, and even at times the action research is shared with the general persons or a common man in terms of the short documentary as well. I'm sure many of you must have seen such documentaries many times, especially through during the news they share this kind of small video clippings that how the situation was earlier, what efforts were taken and how the things are later on. Even at times, especially when the awards are given for social contribution, for educational contribution, even before the award is given, many a times a short film is shown about the awardee. So many a times you would see that such kind of efforts are captured through videos, that how the situation was and how the situation has been changed. So even video, small documentary could be a very good media for sharing the efforts made through the action research. So you know, one can see through these options of reporting an action research that unlike a formal write-up or a research article, of course that could be also an option for action research. But apart from that option, there are so many other creative options where one can really express one's feeling, because this is something, because action research crops up due to something felt at a level of heart that yes, this is my problem and I cannot keep working with this problem keep occurring. So, that kind of feeling and that kind of sharing comes even at the level of report. So, thus the writing the action research report is a creative part, as well as it gives more scope for sharing what is really happening with the practitioner as a human being, or with me in that practitioner, how the things are changing, how the perceptions are changing. And thus it is very much unique as compared to the other types of researches. We have discussed action research in quite detail. We have seen various attributes of it and how it is very, very unique as compared to the other types of researches. Action research is one, that type of research which gives the that confidence to the practitioners that yes, the practice, I can make a difference in my situation, It can be researchable, and research is not something that is happening in the ivory tower or in the isolation in the laboratory situations. So hence it is very much popular, and every teacher should definitely take up the action researches. And in fact, they are the only one who can take up the action researches because they are the persons at the grassroots level. Action research thus gives that moment of pride to all the practitioners to change their situation and to study to what extent the change has happened. And thus, it is a main modality through which even the practitioners can come in the field of academic deliberations and intellectual deliberations. It also helps for taking up the it also helps in taking up the actions here and now for the problem situation. Rather than just building a theory, it has more practical implications, and that is why all the practitioners find this very great connect with this type of research that is the action research.